Recently, I picked up this 201-2 on speculation. It was in a beautiful desk-type cabinet with integrated foot controller. I didn't pay much for it. I think I paid $60 for the whole shoot and match. The machine is from 1951, according to its serial number. At least that's when the serial number was allocated. And it's been sitting around for a couple of weeks now, and I haven't really done anything with it. So there's been a couple of requests for a few 201 specific things that I haven't tackled yet. I've already done a rewire series on these machines. I believe I did something on the needle bar end of these. So what I'm going to do today, there was a request for the bobbin winder. So, I mean, these are pretty simple, but it'll be a short, sweet, and to-the-point video. I'll show you how I do the bobbin winders on these machines. Like many other operations, the first step we're going to do is we're going to take off the stop-motion knob and the balance wheel, just to get it out of our way. Okay, I don't think this tire will be serving us any longer. Okay, you can see somebody's been in here before. That screw head's pretty chowdered up. So we're going to take the motor, we're going to go ahead and we're going to take the motor off of this machine, because I'm not liking the way this is looking. Okay, I've got the machine supported by a block of wood. She's standing on her nose. I'm going to take the power block off once again. I had this off when I took the machine out of her cabinet. Now the motor wires go to terminals 2 and 3, so those are the only screws we have to remove this time around. When I was taking her out of the cabinet, the foot controller wires are on 1 and 2. So, out comes 2 and 3. Get the wire from the lamp back on there. Put the terminal connectors back on. This motor does look like it has been rewired at some point in time. I don't know who did it. So I suspect that it will come off easier than the factory installation will. Let's see how tight these actually are. Oh, not tight at all. Get them loosened. This particular screwdriver, I was at a craft show a couple of weeks back, and there was a gentleman who actually doesn't live far from me. He makes these screwdrivers. He buys the kits from Rockler, and he turns beautiful handles for them. They're reversible. Very, very nice screwdrivers. I bought two of them, one I sent to a friend down in Florida. All right, now we got the screws out. We can lift the motor off, and I will get this carcass out of here. All right, we can tell somebody's been in here, because this screw is completely chowdered up. And I suspect I'm going to have problems getting that off. I'm going to try Big Bertha here. Somebody really cranked this on. All right, I'm putting a Chapman bit into this handle, which gives me really good grip. Okay, we're gonna try heat. Actually, I'm gonna get the paper towel out of the way. I'm applying heat. This blazer torch should get it sufficiently warm. try step number two. Let's get a little Aero-Kroil in from the back. Put it on both of them. See if that'll penetrate down. Aero-Kroil, great penetrating oil. Not a sponsor. Wish they were, because this stuff's expensive. There it goes. Aero-Kroil from the back got down into those threads and it loosened it up just enough. But this screw head is going to take some severe work to fix it. And actually, I do not have great confidence that this screw will live again in this application. Oh my God, that is horrible. Well, there is some depth there yet. And let's take the next one out. Man, that one's coming out without any issue. Okay, I'm going to go over to the bench motor and work my magic and see if I can salvage this screw. Okay, I'm not going to lie to you. I would love to say that I was able to fully resurrect that screw. I was not. And I'll show you. Okay, that's about as good as I was able to get that. And that is still not up to standard. You can see that that has been abused so much in the slot. So I do happen to have a couple of spares, so I'm going to replace that screw. This one, no. I'm not going to put the time into it, at least not right now, to widen that slot. Problem with widening a slot on a screw is then you've got to make sure you've got a screwdriver that fits that correctly. So sometimes you're better off just dropping back 20 and punting and sucking it up and finding a replacement screw. This is why I buy a lot of lots of parts. You know, a seller on eBay will have a lot of parts, you know, offered random things sometimes, but I will buy them because they do come in handy. All right, getting back to this beast. I don't know if that's the right size bit or not. Yes, it is. Very good. We can get in there. And we can take that off. And once again, spring comes out. All right, that's about all we have to do for disassembly on these. So let's get to cleaning parts. We've all seen parts being cleaned before. I don't know if you need to see them being polished or not. I have a couple of videos where I go in excruciating detail how I polish these things. Rather than shoot that here and now, I'm just going to refer you to that. I'll put a link in the description so you can see what parts polishing looks like. Okay, now all the parts are clean, and believe me, they were pretty dirty. I'm going to go ahead and reassemble the bobbin winder. Note, I'm putting it onto a different motor. The motor that just came off of the machine, it needs to be completely rewired and rebuilt. I've already done a series on that. So I happen to keep a couple of spare motors in stock. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this bobbin winder assembly that I just cleaned on this stock motor. And that's the motor that's going to get paired up with this machine as this machine goes through the renovation process. They're all the same. It doesn't really make much difference. Anyway, we'll start with the winder itself, and let me grab my pointer. If I can find, well, I'll use this as a pointer. This will work. Okay, there is a hole for the pin portion of the spring, right at this portion or position, right by this ground out area. So we'll go ahead and get the spring started so that it goes into that, and then we are going to bring the spring back, preloading it. Now, it's a little easier to do in another way, so I'm going to leave that light for the moment. This positions like that, that plate. Just get the screw started a little bit. Now we're going to take this is the screw that normally goes through this side. We're going to put it through there, but we're going to just leave it in there temporarily, just so that the whole shoulder comes in. Take our screwdriver. I really grabbed a big one for this, didn't I? Run that in and get it pretty much, keep that in there so that it gets the plate held in position. As long as that screws all the way down, the shoulder comes up through that hole there, it'll hold the plate in position, which will make our job a lot simpler. So now we're just going to put that in the middle just to position it. Okay, now we make sure that the spring is back in. That's good to go. Notice the position of the hole here that gets the pin on the spring. Put the spring in the hole. Okay, it's in. Now the other little pin or protrusion goes there on the spring. Now this screw has a shoulder. Get the screw started. Once again, I'm holding this in such a way that's trying to make it easier for you to see. There we go. Now it's popped up on there. And we can run that down. All right. Notice we have the spring action. Okay, the last piece to go on. We put our screw through the bracket. Just get the threads started into the motor housing. Okay, it's just started. Now, here's where it can get tricky. This notch here is where this spring is going to go. And the reason why we only got it started, we have to get the arm of the winder down, and then we can push it down so the bobbin follower will lock in. Then and only then do we go in with our screwdriver and run it down. I'm not going to tighten it super tight at the second. I want to double check and get my proper bit in there. Now going with my hollow ground. Okay, now to test, it locks, it unlocks, locks, unlocks. That is working correctly. One thing left, I reach into my bin, I grab a bobbin tire, pop a bobbin tire on, and voila, this motor is ready to be reinstalled. It's only ready to be reinstalled because I've already cleaned this motor. The motor that came off the sewing machine, like I said, is a disgusting, disgusting pit of filth. And that's going to hold off, and I will fix that and clean that one up later on and put it back into stock. Anyway, that's all there is to it. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on the next one.